I am going to be sitting with my knee between Coach Jason's legs and my other foot. My heel is going to be touching Coach Jason's hip. In my opinion, that is the most important part of the straight foot lock. Everything else, nothing else really matters. I'm going to squeeze everything together, that way there's no space, that way he can't wiggle. And then, yeah. My wrist bone is going to be connected right here. I'm going to have this kind of grip. Just like this. Now, see how my elbow's kind of posted? I don't want that. I want my elbow to be next to my hip. I'm gonna lean, and then I'm going to look behind me for the tap. Again, this grip, make this grip, my elbow's flared, I tuck, and then my shoulder is going to touch the mat, and I bridge. Now, this is really important because my lower body needs to push off of something. If my foot is free, then it doesn't really work because I have no leverage. I need to push off his hip. So if I don't have a connection right here, I have nothing to push off of, it won't work. I have seen some people use straight foot lock in this position. I rarely ever see it work on somebody who knows what they're doing. You usually need to have your foot right here. Then tuck, shoulder drops, and then bridge. Now, to do this legally in a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu tournament, your foot cannot come across here because then you're putting your opponent's knee in danger. Foot stays here, point the toes, and then lean onto my shoulder, and then bring everything up. Does anybody have any questions so far?
Can you rather come across
the head? This one? I don't recommend it because if I do this, then Coach Jason can attack my foot. So for example, Coach, can you get a regular straight foot lock on me? So he's got a regular straight foot lock, and I can't really attack his leg legally. But the second this foot comes out, I can attack here, or this is my favorite, I can attack right here. He's in a lot of danger. So this has a lot of names. I call it the Texas Cloverleaf. A lot of people call it this. I do this, I do the little Hulk Hogan pose, and I break both. So it's best not to have your foot exposed. If Coach Jason's right here, I can't really attack this. I need to get this into this position, and then I can attack him.
So keep this up and keep the shoe.
From this position? Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
And you can start grabbing his arms.
All kinds of stuff that can happen. Yes, but from here, I've got mounts. Because if Coach Jason's here, I can come up here. Boom. So, it's best to keep this knee shield in as long as you can. Does anybody have any questions so far? All right, we're gonna keep it simple until we get to the next section. So practice the positioning, and bad guy, let your opponent know if you feel it. They should either feel their instep breaking, or they should feel pain here. If they feel pain in here, that's not terrible, but that's not what we want. Pain here or here. All right, let's go. Ready? One, two, three.
Yeah.